What is the best email automation platform? And did you know that most of the email automation platforms are not designed for online marketers? They are designed for businesses. And sadly enough, most of the YouTube videos that talk about email marketing automation or autoresponders, I'm talking about email responders, they get it absolutely wrong. And I'm going to prove it to you. Hello, Mark Daniels here, and I want to welcome you to this epic training. This is going to be about the best email automation platform, or you can call it the best email software. Now, it's also the same thing as email autoresponder, but there's a lot of things that I'm going to go ahead and just go through a lot of stuff that you probably never heard of before, simply because if you are watching some YouTube videos on YouTube, a lot of times they tell you, okay, well, what is the top five autoresponder or best email automation platform and so forth. This is all junk. Don't listen to that stuff because I'm going to reveal some secrets. I've been doing this for over 12, 13 years so far, and I have done a lot of work with a lot of entrepreneurs, and it's always the same way. And I'm talking about, you know, what is the best email responder? Remember, the email responders or the email automation platform, usually they have been created, the old ones, they have been created for businesses, not for marketers. So I'm going to go ahead and just talk about that a little bit here. We're going to go over some really important stuff here. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, in order for you to succeed, there are a few things that you have to understand. One of them is, can you take a chance with the best email automation platform because you have just somebody talked about it, or somebody just like mentioned that it's a good thing to do, or what have you? You really cannot take any chances, and I'm going to tell you why. Now, let's go ahead and get started here. Why list is so important, as far as you understand. Now, we're talking about something that is very important to a lot of people. Now, if you are a marketer, obviously what you are doing is very simple. You are trying to get people to opt in or try to sell them something. And obviously, most people don't buy the first time. And I get a lot of emails on that or regarding that. Is that, nobody bought, or just 1% or 2% bought? Most people don't buy the first time around. You just have to understand that. So that's why you have to have the very best software that does these things for you. But a lot of these email automation platform, they are not designed for email marketers and so forth. So you got to understand that. Now, the other thing is that you must have the right email automation platform. Now, how would you determine what is the best one for you? Now, when you take a look at email automation platform, you find nothing but confusion. There's a lot of them out there, and you just don't know which one to pick and which one is the best for what you want to do. I'm not talking about businesses. I'm not talking about like, okay, if you have a business, you're selling something, you can use whatever you want to. But if you are selling anything online, or even you have a shop and you want to sell other people, nowadays, a lot of these things have changed a lot. Now, I'm going to go ahead and tell you a little bit more secrets about this, and just understand that most of these, or some of those, not all of them, are not designed for online marketers or online affiliate marketers. You know by now that the best email automation platform must be affiliate friendly. And you're probably asking, Mark, why is that? Why does it have to be affiliate friendly? I'm not selling anything with affiliate marketing. So the reason for that is very simple, is because in order for you to succeed, you have to have an MSI, which is multiple sources of income. And if you take a look at the top affiliate or the top online marketers, not necessarily affiliates, because almost all of them have their own products. But in order for you to succeed, for example, you have to sell other things. All online marketers sell affiliate products. All of them. Never seen anyone just selling his own or her own product. You have to sell other people's product as well. In order for you to do that, you have to do certain things. So let's go ahead and go to number two here. I'm going to go ahead and tell you a little bit about the best automation platform dirty secret. A lot of people just don't know about these things, and it's very important for you to understand that 99% of all the email automation platforms that you see out there, they are not affiliate friendly. And I'm going to prove it to you here in just a little bit. Number two, I'm going to go ahead and just go and talk about Mailchimp. A lot of people, they're just like, oh, Mailchimp, it is the best email automation platform or best email autoresponder. And well, I'm going to tell you something. It's not. The reason people use it a lot, because when they first got started, they were like the first one to offer free account. And a lot of people got into the bandwagon. But I'm going to go ahead and just prove that to you, that they're not friendly to affiliate marketers. Again, affiliate marketing is not that important. If you don't think so, then this is the wrong thing for you. You listen to the wrong video, because if you're selling anything online, even if you're selling your own product, you need to be selling other people's product. It doesn't cost you anything. So make sure to really understand that. So what are we going to do? We're going to go to Mailchimp acceptable use policy. And let's go ahead and go there. Now, when you go there, this is Mailchimp, obviously. You just go down here and you look under the prohibited content, and you can take a look right here. It says affiliate marketing. And not only that, they'd also have some other things that you might be interested in selling, but a lot of people don't tell you about it, and they don't sit there and advertise it. Okay. Now, affiliate marketing is prohibited. In other words, if they know later on, or if you are wondering why your email are not successful, why things are not happening the way you want to, now you know why. So Mailchimp is not that good for you. A lot of people, they overrate that, and they think it's the best thing since sliced bread. It is really not. So now we're covering all these. Now let's go ahead and talk about ActiveCampaign. A lot of people talk to me about ActiveCampaign, and they talk that it is the best thing since sliced bread as well. As a matter of fact, I had an issue with one of the marketers. So what I did is I opened an account, okay, and I paid for it. I opened an account and I start to do affiliate marketing. Within 1 week or so, they stopped my account, and they said that I'm violating their rules or policy. So why is that? Even though the other person was doing probably affiliate marketing, but he also mostly was actually selling his own product. So let's go ahead and go to ActiveCampaign. Now, if you go to ActiveCampaign, of course, you go to the acceptable policy, and then you go down here. And then under this right here, it says additional scrutiny, which is not just additional scrutiny. They did shut down one of the accounts. I opened the account just for testing because I don't use them, but I just want to make sure that the stuff that I'm giving you is active and it's real and it's a genuine information. So I spent money just to test it, and sure enough, it tells you a lot of things. It tells you that affiliate marketing, if you take a look right here, is prohibited, even loans, and they have a lot of stuff too. I just want to make sure that you understand that ActiveCampaign, I'm not saying it's a bad platform, but they're just not friendly to affiliate marketers. Even if you are selling your own product, you have to have something that is going to be friendly for affiliate marketing, because if you want to succeed, you have to do the same thing as the big guys, and you want to do MSI, which is multiple streams of income. And the only way you do that is by having something that is going to actually work for you as far as that. Then we're going to talk a little bit more in depth, not in depth, but I'm just going to tell you what the consequences. Now, if you go to drip, a lot of people also use the drip. It's one of the oldest one out there. And if you go to the terms of service regarding that, and if you, you know, terms of service, and then you go down all the way to the categories require additional scrutiny, you can tell that affiliate marketing is right here. Not only that, it's also real estate, okay, dating and relationship, which is a very big market. And of course they have mortgage and loan, so they really have a whole lot of stuff out there that you really don't want to be involved in. Again, if you don't follow this information, the stuff that I'm talking about, it is going to be very difficult for you, because you have to later on change the platform or try to find the platform. So don't worry about that, because I already tested all the platform that I'm just going to give to you here in just a little bit. Now, if you are using some of these, obviously these are not the only one, because I cannot, you know, sit there and do all of them, because it takes a long time. Now, I just want to mention something here. Kartra. I'm sure you've heard of Kartra, which is similar to ClickFunnels, but they do have also their email marketing platform. I just want to let you know something, that even Kartra, when they send their email, it doesn't end up right here. If you are using Gmail, it doesn't end up, because they're new, and they have some, even though they are friendly for affiliate marketers, they don't have any issues with affiliate marketers, but at the same time, they don't have a very good proven email platform that is trusted by most email marketing like Gmail, Hotmail, and so forth. So it'll end up either in a spam, we have tested it, or it'll end up in some kind of a promotional up here where your customer or your prospect does not actually see it. All right, let's go now to right here. Best trick for your email not to end up in a spam folder. A lot of people, even if you are using a trusted, or if you are using a platform that is friendly for affiliate or to affiliate marketers, a lot of times when you send that email, especially the first or the second email, what happens is that, let's say Gmail is not used to you. Now the platform or the email, it might be good. For example, the one that I'm going to give to you, they have good reputation as far as delivery email, and they are trusted by the big guys like Gmail, Hotmail, and so forth. But sometimes when you first get started, you're going to attach basically your name or a platform or maybe a website or what have you. So they don't really know you very well. So I'm going to show you exactly to make sure that that doesn't end up in a spam folder or not delivered at all. There's a little trick that you can do. In the first or second email, you have to ask a question. For example, if you are, let's say they opted in and then they are receiving a gift, maybe an ebook or something like that. Of course, you don't need to do that. That's not what I mean by that. Of course, they're not going to say anything bad about you. But the second email that you sent in, okay, if you're not sending anything for like a gift or something of value that the customer or the prospect is not going to complain about. So the second email that you send in, what you want to do is ask a question. For example, what is the biggest challenge you are facing? For example, if you are in affiliate marketing or if you are in health and fitness, it really doesn't matter. What you want is this. When you send this email to your prospect, what is the best, you know, what is the biggest challenge that you have? Okay. And what they do is they think, okay, you're going to send them something good, which you will. But at least what they do is they email you back. When that happens, like, for example, a Gmail or big email providers, Hotmail and so forth, they put you in a trusted bucket. In other words, they know that the customer or the prospect is not complaining. Actually, they are communicating with you. So you're okay. Okay, you see what I mean? So everything is fine. You are talking with them and they are sending you something. So this is the biggest thing. This is will train the email AI, which is artificial intelligence, that this person is okay. So you don't have to worry about that. Now, as far as the what are the best automation platform, for example, I'm gonna go ahead and provide that in the description so you can see that. Now, all of them are free to get started, and some of them are free, totally free. So what I mean by free is very simple. Of course, a lot of platforms, they will give you access for free, but they might not give you the full all access that they have. But I want you to do something for me and to do it for yourself. Do not be cheap on the way to your success. I get emails too about people that they want to use a free. I'm talking about totally free email automation platform. And this is the worst thing that you can do. If somebody is offering you something forever, I'm talking about, okay, yeah, this is free. You have to understand that. They have to have a relationship with the big email providers. And there are a lot of things that go into it. And the last thing you want is using something really, using something cheap, totally cheap or maybe free, and end up really not accomplishing what you want to do. So make sure you are not making that mistake. If you want to succeed, there are things that you have to do. If you want to know everything about affiliate marketing for beginners, click up here. If you want to know about how to start your affiliate marketing journey and the tools that you need, click here. And as usual, I'll see you at the top.